The chapters assigned for this module introduce us to two aspects of technology that have changed the way businesses work. Those two aspects are social computing and e-commerce. We've already learned that technology is increasing at a very fast rate, and the internet also has matured over the years. It's grown beyond simply hyperlinks to include many more powerful features. These features are so powerful that we refer to this as the Web 2.0, which is a new and better web experience. Some of the features that are specific to Web 2.0 include Ajax. And Ajax is a web development technique, kind of a programming language for the web that enables users to refresh just parts of a web page without having to reload the entire web page. And this makes web pages a lot faster and more responsive. Then there's tagging, and you're probably familiar with the concept of hashtagging, which allows people to categorize blogs and pictures and videos by, a new term perhaps to use, folksonomies. It's even hard for me to say. But folksonomies would include places where users categorize their own web pages and photos and videos, and probably the best example of this would be Pinterest. And then, of course, there are blogs, and blogs are short for weblog, and that's a personal website usually. It's open to the public, and the website creator writes about their feelings, their opinions, whether it be politics or reviewing particular products. Some of the other features with Web 2.0 include microblogging. Those are just real small, short messages, and of course, Twitter is probably one of the best examples of that. Then there's wikis, which is made up entirely of user-generated content, and Wikipedia is an example of that. And then there are social networking websites, which allow people to put their own profile pages and post their own blog entries and pictures and videos and music and other things that interest them. And of course, Facebook and LinkedIn on the business side would be good examples of social networking websites. Web 2.0 has given us another way to do business known as social commerce. And social commerce is the delivery of electronic commerce activities and transactions directly through the social computing. And it also allows the customers to participate in the marketing and selling and reviewing of the products and services. And we're going to talk about some of the benefits to customers and the benefits to businesses in the next couple of slides. There are lots of benefits to customers in social commerce, and those benefits include better and faster responses from the vendor. If you want to have a complaint, you might be able to get your answer directly from Facebook or Twitter or YouTube. Customers can assist other customers. There could be a user-generated support page or a wiki for the particular product. Customers are going to get their expectations met more fully and quickly, because if they don't, with social commerce, they'll be able to post those reviews that might not reflect the company in a favorable light. And customers can also link and search and chat with each other, all while staying within their particular social network site. Of course, there are also lots of benefits to businesses with social commerce, and some of those benefits include the ability for businesses to quickly test new products or ideas by just posting an idea out on a social networking site and seeing how people react to it. They can learn a lot more about their customers by examining the social responses, social media posts. They can identify problems quickly if several people start complaining on the social media site about a particular product or service. They can respond to that quickly. They get rapid feedback from their customers, and they can also increase sales when they use customers as their marketing tools. If customers like the product and discuss it positively on the social networking site, that will obviously increase sales for the business very inexpensively. There are even more benefits to business, and some of those also include more effective marketing campaigns that are exactly able to target exactly who they're looking for using demographics that Facebook or Google would provide, for instance. They can use low-cost generated content. I talked about that. If users like the product, they're very likely to tell other people, and they can also hope that they will obtain free advertising through viral marketing. And one of the best examples of that has been one of the Old Spice ads, where everybody shared it, and the company was able to get way more traction out of the ad than if they had just simply placed it on TV. Social computing has also changed the shopping experience for consumers. And one of the most powerful ways that it's changed shopping for consumers is the ability to look up ratings and reviews. Before you buy a product, you might go out to Amazon and look at the ratings and the reviews for that particular product, or do it through Google. There's also group shopping sites such as Groupon and Living Social that offer discounts for a specific time. And then there's peer-to-peer shopping models. And these have replaced the old classified, some newspapers still have classified classified ads, but in most cases, the classified ad section are a lot smaller than they used to be, and they've been replaced with things like Craigslist or a for sale group on Facebook. Social computing also helps the human resources department in companies. A couple of ways that social computing can help is through recruiting. Both recruiters and job seekers are moving to online social networks, Indeed and CareerBuilder and even Craigslist to look for ads. And then employee development. HR professionals use social tools to encourage and promote employee development by building relationships. And this would include things like e-training and e-learning, and also wikis where employees can kind of share their information and make sure that the new employees get trained and feel like they're part of the group. E-commerce is business that's done electronically, and some of the different methods in which business is done include business-to-consumer, where businesses sell directly to consumers, business-to-business, where businesses buy from each other, there's consumer-to-consumer, such as Craigslist, there's business-to-employee, there's e-government, specifically for working with government, and there's mobile commerce and quite a few others, as you can see on the list here. Some of the specific methods that are used in e-commerce include auctions, and one of the best-known auctions is eBay. There's electronic storefronts, where you just go to Amazon.com or electronic malls. There's electronic marketplaces, where you have a lot of buyers and sellers that you're putting things together. And an Alibaba would be an example of a B2B, business-to-business marketplace. And there are lots of benefits to e-commerce. The organization benefits because they're able to access a national or even an international market without having to have a brick-and-mortar store in every place. Consumers are able to access a lot more products. They can shop for prices. And, of course, society benefits because everybody everywhere can get the same products easily, even rural areas and developing countries. Well, business still requires marketing, and Web 2.0 has changed marketing a little bit, and some of the specific ways that companies market online would include banner ads. You've seen those, big videos or just a picture up at the top of the web page. There's pop-up ads, those annoying ads that appear and block the content for a while. There's also spam. That's just the indiscriminate distribution of emails without permission, and that is actually illegal. Then there is permission marketing, where the company specifically asks, do you want to be included in our mailing list? Do you want to get our emails? And then there's viral marketing, which I already mentioned a little bit before. That's where word of mouth gets around and people share, and before long everybody is hearing about this new product or this exciting service.